Scary shrooms. Yeah, so scary. Oh man. Okay. So I'm gonna actually see something, because, like, if you remember, well, it wasn't that long ago, because, so obviously you remember, but I wonder if it's possible to actually get up there without going to the slide. Right, so if I... maybe. Let me give a few more tries. I don't wanna triple jump that low. Okay. Nah, I'm gonna have to do some stupid tricks to do that, so... never mind, we're gonna have to do the slide again. So, I'll just meet you guys past the slide, because I don't think you want to see that again. And we're done. Actually died a few times there, but we got it. So, I think I remember where the bourbon body is. So I'm gonna try. Yeah, I'm doing everything before the star it tells me to do, like just like back in Bourbon Battlefield. And I just like how you can do whatever. Most of the time, you can do whatever star you want. And Galaxy and Sunshine do have the benefits of being more episode-like. So it has more of a chance to flesh out the worlds and stuff like that, but I don't know, I like this as well, like just being able to fall and miss your target completely. But yeah, I just like the style. And I wish they did it again. Like, Mario 64 DS, I guess, counts, but I'm talking about a 100% new game, not a remake. I still need to play 64DS. I'm not really sure if I'll do anything with it, like, in terms of, like, recording or streams or anything, but, I'll think about that down the road, I suppose. Maybe. Not really sure how much demand there will be for it, but I doubt I do a playthrough, but if people want to stream, I might oblige. We'll see. Maybe a blind stream. I could potentially long jump down there, but you know, screw it, I'm gonna try that. Oh my gosh! Okay. Forget the old plan, we're not doing. We're not using the cannon. Okay. Now we pretty much have to go to the top of the mountain, so... yeah, thankfully, we can speed the process up a little bit. So we just got up here. We pretty much skip half of it. Half of the mountain climbing business. So that's always good. Okay. slightly careful. I don't usually find it that difficult to walk in a straight line in this game, so... And I want to just check something. I want to see if the... Yeah, we're not going to do that. I'm going to check Star 5, just because, like, there's that switch we saw before the star there. And I'm wondering if that was that's what we need for the star in Mission 5. Oh, that could have been bad. Alright. Okay, so we just go up here like normal. Nice! Okay, whatever, I'll just go the slow way. There's one of the monkeys. That's not the one we want. Okay. So if we just go through here, and then I guess drop down. Oh gosh. Yeah, okay. That works. It's actually pretty clever. Not too confusing, but it makes you think a little bit, I guess. I already knew that was like... I already knew the gist of it, but... I forgot if you had to actually deal with the monkey first or not. Because I know that has its own star, but... I forgot if it actually activated something else. But apparently not. Just do this again. Yeah. Yeah, the thing of this world is that it's just pretty much you're doing the same things over and over. Like, just you have to keep scaling the mountain constantly, the mountain is designed fine enough, it's just a little bit repetitive, just doing basically going really high up over and over. But it's a good thing that it's. They give you a few shortcuts. But yeah, I just think it would be better if they place the stars more sparingly, instead of just having like half of them, pretty much like four or so of them at like the top. Oh, come on, I clearly got him there. Yeah, this monkey can be a bit annoying. Yeah, you thought the rabbit was annoying to deal with. This is just why. I'm trying to trick him. It's just that jump. There we go. Okay. Sure. I like little monkey. I like monkeys. Yeah, you can't grab him again. Wait, can you walk through him? Yeah, you can, okay. What? Oh man, that's weird. You don't exactly have a monkey head for a butt, but it's close enough. And there we go. Here we go. And if I'm right, that means we only have the last area to go. So let's bail out of this place. Finally go into the last area, and actually looks pretty nice. Yeah, just a little bluish color palette. It just blends in really well with the stars on the walls and stuff. So first off, we're going to be doing this because this is really annoying when you fail this, so I want to get this out of the way. So basically, it's a eight red coin mission again. So what we're going to have to do is get these suckers and try our best not to end up falling into the abyss. Because if you do that, you're going to be sent all the way back to the outside of the castle and trying to... Well, it doesn't take that long to get back, but it's annoying regardless, so I want to get this out of the way now, so don't have to worry about it later. But yeah, definitely the worst, well, in my opinion, I'd say this is the worst red coin mission in the game. Just for the fact that if you fail it, you have to go all the way back, which is just tedious in and of itself. So, you want to be careful not to... No, I'm going to bonk onto that, so I'm not going to try that. I failed. Can you reach that, please? I don't remember if you bonk on clouds. It wouldn't make sense, but I'm not going to chance it. So what I'm going to do is go up there. Yeah, I don't really have much of a plan on this stage. So... try and land up there. There we go. Land. Don't fall, whatever you do. Ah, that's not good. How do I guess I'm just gonna have to use the cannon. Ugh. I just hate how it's so easy to mess this up, because this platform where we're trying to get to is what usually causes me to fall. Come on. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, that's the worst part. Okay. I think up there. Oh, careful. And... oh, there's one there. The cloud. Now I just go back and go onto that, those poles. Or just fly to it. Oh! Wait, what? Please tell me just... Okay, good. I was scared for a sec. Thankfully, you don't fall straight through them. And if we're good, we should be home free. Okay. That's done. So I remember in my last... Oh yeah, that's right, this is a replay. I keep saying welcome back to Let's Play Mario 64 when in reality this is actually a replay. My bad. But yeah, in my original playthrough, I remember having so many issues with that stage. But with age and experience, it's not that bad anymore.
There's something strange about that clock. Is he jumping?
Yeah. Nah. No, I'm not gonna even try that. But final Toad Star is right here.
Yep.
And now we just have two more stages and one more Bowser level, so let's do this. So the gimmick of this stage is that depending on when you dive into the clock here, that will determine like how fast things move in the level. So if you go in there when the big hand is on the 12, it basically makes him stop moving entirely, and then you just have to basically time it to your advantage, depending on like when would work the best for you. But yeah, I actually really like this level. It's very platform heavy, and I'd say it's the most platform heavy stage in the game, and it has a bunch of cool stuff in it. I guess I don't know. I don't know how to explain. I don't know what I was trying there, to be honest. So wait, I wonder if I do it right after 12, it's gonna go really fast. No, that's actually kind of slow. Cause I actually want to get a fast one. Cause then I can actually get a star really quickly. Oh god. But yeah, I just like the platforming challenges here. The red coins can be a little bit annoying to get, but thankfully they're near the start. So, if we just go down here... Oh, wait. I'll do this first. I've never actually done that. Didn't really plan that, but we don't really... Well, we shouldn't have to worry about this one. In theory. Alright, it's going faster. A lot faster. Yeah, you really have to try to get knocked out back by those pendulums. I don't even know if they... Well, I know you can... I know they're physical. Not physical, but like, they're solid objects, I should say, but I don't think they can really do much. You really have to try to dive on them. Alright. Okay, I'm gonna try getting the red coins. Because it's actually... Because it's actually not the... Okay, no, that's actually too fast. I'll get a different star for this. But, this one... for this level... 100 coins stacked us on top of the 8 red coin star isn't exactly the best. Because seeing how... The 8 red coins are so close to the beginning. Trying to get 100 coins, then going back for that red coin star can be a little bit risky because you have a really high chance of just committing suicide instead. So, I'm just gonna, well, get one of these stars up here first, and then make everything go a little bit, well, quite a lot slower actually. This is way too fast, but yeah, do that, and then and then get the 8 red coin star, and then when the star that requires you to basically go to the top of this place is when I'm gonna get 100 coins. Yeah, but even there, even here, like when the pendulums are used as a massive obstacle, it's really easy to predict it. Again, you really have to suck. Oh, excuse me. Okay, I want to make it really slow. This should be fine. I always hated this, though. Yeah, look at this. This is really annoying to do. Like, I think it's possible to do it with them completely stopped, but it's a lot more difficult. So you're better off just making them move a little bit. But even then, you're still gonna have a hard time. Nah, this ain't Undertale. Come on. You can drop down here from an upper path, but I'm gonna make sure I get as many of them as I can from this point, from down here. But yeah, if it weren't for the fact that you had to deal with falling in the red coin star in the clouds, and having to go all the way back to the top of the castle in that mission, I would say that this would be worse than that one, just because of how annoying this can be. But yeah. Okay, that works. Thankfully, the mission, not the last one, because it's about one in the Bowser level, but the 8 red coin mission in the last main level is a lot more bearable than this. It's actually pretty easy. Maybe it would have been easier if I just stopped time. Well, not literally, but you know what I mean. Okay, time this right. Okay. What? Okay, I'm just gonna stop it. I'm just gonna make them stop. See if that makes anything easier. I think I missed it. I don't know. Is that gonna count? No, I messed up. Alright. Yeah, I'm not exiting the course, because that's going to make us go all the way back to the main area, the main hall. There we go. Now let's see if this actually makes it easier. Maybe it will. Okay. Yeah, it is actually easier. My bad. I thought I actually made this harder. Whoop whoop. Okay. I was proven wrong. That was a lot easier. Well, I wasted a bunch of you guys' time, but. Wasn't that. I'll look back obviously, but I don't think it was that long. I didn't want to jump in just yet. That should be okay though. Okay, I don't need things moving for this one. I'm not gonna get 100 coins just yet. This is the last one before I'm gonna do that. I'm really hoping I don't screw that up though, because Oh man. I hate it when Mario does that. Again, stop giving me heart attacks. But yeah, so, as you can clearly see, it's very easy to mess up and die in these layer levels. So, yeah, just trying getting really close to the top and then dying is really demotivating. Alright. More stars to go. Oh, okay, let me actually time this. That should be okay. Because I want it to be pretty slow, but yeah, that works. Okay.